Doctors, what's it like when you get sick? Do you go to the doctor or diagnose yourself? Doc here. As a general rule, med students are hypochondriacs, doctors are invincible. I remember at uni. Every week the med students all thinking they had whatever weird condition they were studying that week. Same for virology students though. The sexual health clinic gets way busier when they start studying STIs. This is actually a thing. It's called medical student syndrome. My pediatrician once told me an amusing story about when her daughter got sick. She brought her daughter into urgent care among her coworkers and was freaking out, not sure what could be wrong with her daughter. Her coworkers looked at her and went, "You're a pediatrician. I know, but I can't think straight. My mom's a nurse and has seen some horrible things. She almost passed out when I shattered my arm." Sure, it's definitely different when it's your kid. This may vary according to your country. But if I get sick, I can diagnose myself in the sense that I can say, yep, this is probably X. I should do this and that test or take this or the drugs, but I cannot self-prescribe anything. I need another doctor to prescribe it for me. No pharmacy can accept a prescription with the same name for the doctor and the patient. And no clinic can accept a request for an eczema, monsieur. The only exception is for use in an emergency. In that case, I can self-prescribe. How does this emergency scenario work? The pharmacist just has to agree that it's medically necessary? I actually explained the situation a bit badly. I'm sorry. If you ask it because you have an emergency right now, it works like you said. This is true for any citizen. You have to convince the pharmacist that you absolutely need it, like you are a diabetic and forgot your insulin, or you are under antibiotics for a serious infection and lost your bags with a drug inside. Stuff like that. Being in the system or having any paper to show obviously helps a lot. If you usually buy insulin, there you are in their system. And they can check that you usually have a prescription and it's not like diabetes just disappear. If you are taking antibiotics for a serious infection, you probably has been in an hospital recently. You can show your discharge paper that states what you had. Obviously, the pharmacy is going to give you the minimum dose necessary. You can't stock on a month of insulin without a prescription. Now going back on tracks. What I meant for emergency is thing I need for an emergency. Let's say that I want to have in my office some adrenaline. I can self-prescribe, labeling the prescription as self-prescription and paying it all out of my pocket. As far as I know, the Italian law is not particularly strict on what is drug for emergency, but every colleague that I know seems to err on the safe side. My father is a doc. He had been having shortness of breath and chest tightness worsening over a few months. One day, after work was done and the clinic was closed, he hopped in the CT scanner and read his own CT scan. Massively enlarged lymph nodes all through his body, lymphoma. He's alive and well after diagnosing himself with cancer years ago. Edit. Holy shit. This blew up. To address FAQs. He is a partner in a private practice group that owns their own outpatient centers. Thus, he was able to use the scanner informally. Yes, I know we are privileged to be a medical family, and he is so lucky to have access to care that isn't affordable for a huge chunk of the US population. Medicare for all. I'm not sure if he had a partner stay behind to help with the scanner. I'll have to ask. And he is 17 or so odd years in remission from stage 4 non-Hodgkin's lymphoma and doing fantastic. Retiring in a month after 45 years in radiology. Good to hear. My mother has lymphoma and chemo didn't work, so now we are just hopelessly waiting the end. Fuck cancer. The saying, "Doctors make the worst patients," is true for a reason. Most of the doctors I work with, myself included, wouldn't hesitate to diagnose ourselves, and have on many occasions. Obviously, this comes with some bias, but I like to think that I'm able to tell the difference between A. this isn't serious, I can deal, versus B. maybe it's time to get a real workup. On that note, I have a particular anecdote. My attending lead doctor while I'm in residency recently had an emergency appendectomy. He has a history of kidney stones and assumed that acute right lower quadrant pain was another one. By the time he realized maybe this is a situation B, his appendix had become gangrenous. Edit. Holy crap, this blew up overnight. Got a busy day, but I'll try and respond to a lot of the questions as the day goes on. Figured I'd clarify a couple things that were touched on in other posts. 1. My attending is just fine. Got his appendix removed and was back at work the next week. 2. The whole self-diagnosis thing only goes so far. Really depends on the severity of your issue and how much workup is required. For instance, if it's a suspected muscle strain or something, I'll easily diagnose myself and do appropriate stretches. If I'm a little unsure, maybe ask a colleague for an informal second opinion, because it's not that serious and requires minimal workup. Essentially a diagnosis made by exam. This is no issue. However, if let's say, I think this might be more serious, I think I need a CT scan or something. You can't just do that on your own. You need to actually book yourself an appointment and get formal one up. Those scans aren't cheap and you can't just sneak your way in. Plus, I wouldn't trust myself to read the images. 3. If I'm confident I have a mild infection, let's say for example pink eye, I wouldn't necessarily go to the clinic and waste an afternoon, money, but would just ask a colleague for a prescription for the appropriate eye drops. 4. You technically can write prescriptions for your family, but it can be frowned upon and seen as suspicious depending what it is. X. An antibiotic versus large amounts of oxy. It is pretty difficult to write a script for yourself though. 5. Another anecdote. In college I had significant anxiety. My dad, a radiologist, reads x-rays, CTs, etc., not knowing anything about psych issues, wrote me a long-standing Rx for lorazepam, a benzo like Xanax. This was not the right thing, but I didn't know better. It was essentially a band-aid that didn't attack the problem at the source. Not to mention studies have since come out saying daily benzo use can contribute to end of life dementia. I didn't really tackle my problem until I started seeing a psychiatrist and got on an SSRI instead. This is an example of how it can bite you in the ass. 6. Last anecdote. I have what is called a lipoma on my abdomen. A benign, painless fat cell tumor that is, for me, the size of a quarter. Some can get massive, really just anesthetic, but not harmful. Instead of formal, paid workup, I went to my mom, who is an ultrasound tech, to get a free scan. Then I brought the image to my dad, a radiologist, who interpreted it as just a lipoma. Nothing to worry about, so I did get a formal workup, but not through formal channels. And now I'm happy living with my lipoma carefree. I named him Stevie. If you guys have any other questions, I'm more than happy to answer. AMA, I guess. Same principle applies in other industries too. When a stubborn sysadmin calls a vendor for help and gets told that the problem is definitely X, he'll usually reply with "there's no way it's X." We've all got an internal battle between the need for help and the need to not need help. My friend's parents are GPs, and there are laws in the UK so you can't be formally diagnosed etc. by family members. So as a kid their parent would take them to the DRS like they have this, this and this, and the other doctor would just nod and prescribe medicine, haha. I cry to my wife, who is also a doc, and then proceed to refuse every remedy she offers me. First, that's hilarious. Second, I have to ask, what's your wife's reaction? And what happens when your wife gets sick? She goes to a proper medical doctor. Because he left out that neither of them are doctors of medicine. I'm a veterinarian. When my own pets get sick, I turn into a useless, crying idiot. Luckily, I have good colleagues to turn to. MVET Tech. I was helping one of our doctors x-ray her rescue dog's chest due to a cough. I looked at the picture and pointed out she has a bullet in her side. She almost lost it right there. I come from a family of doctors. I am a doctor, and I grew up knowing basically every doctor in my area. The best story I got is about a doctor we will call Grabo, perhaps one of the most senior and respected internal medicine doctors in my area. My dad is a workaholic. He loves medicine more than anything, and if he could do anything, it would likely be spending more time in the hospital. Me? Not so much. Dad and Dr. Grabo were very similar in how much they love their work. Dad and Grabo over the years became good friends and had a sort of direct and cynical humor they shared with each other. At one point, my dad cracked a joke at Grabo because he again showed up to work even though he was a bit sick. Dad asked, "Greater than hey Gray, when do you think you are going to retire? You're getting pretty old and we don't want to have to pick you up off the floor here at some point." Grabo replied, "Greater than I'll never retire. Wait, yeah, I'll ... when I die ... Grabo never retired. A few years later, he was driving back home from an outing with his middle-aged son and he started having a heart attack. While I assume he was experiencing the severe and horrible pain of a heart attack, he just looked over at his son and said, "Greater than I am sorry. I am having a heart attack." He passed away after pulling over. The man apologized to his son for having a heart attack that he was completely aware of. I can't say I would have handled that like he did. RIP Dr. Gray. That dude was a badass. Thank you so much for watching and have a good day.